getting the whole country. And now let's start the journey, how we as a parent and teachers can help our children in career planning. If we are teacher, then we might be a parent also. So how we can help our kids, help our children to plan their career? What is this career planning and what is its significance in this new era? And how the children are going to jump into their careers? So what should be the scenario of this? What should be the proper way of this? And what happens actually when it is not going to be planned properly? So this whole science we are going to discuss under the banner of People Trainers and Binora ECS today. And scope of today's session, we are going to remain here for next 70 minutes approx. In 70 minutes, un 70 minuton mein, we are going to discuss a lot how to help our children to do career planning, to explore career options, to choose the best career options for them, and trace the pathways of success in their chosen career options, and take actions to achieve career, means to execute whatever they have planned to move ahead. So this whole we are going to discuss today. Before moving ahead, aage badhne se pehle, I would like to know from you people, let's brainstorm here at the topic that is career planning. Actually, what do you think by this term career planning? I would like to know from you people. Aapse janna chahunga ki career planning se aapka kya tatpar hai? What do you think by this term? And how this is significant nowadays? Aajkal iska kitna significance hai, kitna mahatva hai? Please, aapki bari. Aapne se jisko bhi isko answer karna ho, you just open your mic or raise your hand and start just answering it. You can open your mic, speak, yani aap bol sakte hain. You can write it in the chat box, yani aap likh ke bata sakte hain. Yes.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Ji, Harbin ji. Baji mari aapne taali aapke liye. Yes. Bahut badhiya.
So, in simple way, I think career planning is related to just to choose the career path as per the ability and capability, and to relate with skills where we are interested and we have interest to do the something better.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Thank you. You are absolutely, yes. Absolutely right. You tried well. And then others also, please. Humme se har aadmi ke paas ek jawab ho sakta hai iska. Please introduce. Because we are a small room, so let's do a good and great brainstorming so that the topics which we are discussing should be learnt and become a part of our learning now and here only. Yahi se hum isko pakka karke chalein. Yes. Others, what do you think about it, career planning? Okay, no answer. So let's move ahead. So I'm just going to put its answer. What is this and why this is important? Actually, this is a process to decide career goals first and then move ahead in the academics. Decide career goals first and then move ahead for the career goals. So career goals should be decided before achieving, before moving ahead, rather than what we are doing in this country. Majority of the students are studying first. Academically, they are performing their academic courses, and then they are deciding what they will do in the career. And rather, they are not at the stage of that after graduation, post-graduation, even two. Yani itna padhne ke baad bhi clarity nahi hoti. So this process is required to stop, and the actually career planning says that you decide first and then move then later. So ye tha, aajkal ye bachchon ke liye bahut jaruri hai. This is very much significant because the country like India is suffering a lot in the terms of education. Education is for the betterment of life, people, society. But here, education is not doing betterment. It is creating challenges and struggles for the majority of the people. And there is no surety that after taking education, you will get success, your life will become good. There is no surety. So this surety quotient is required to enhance, and to enhance this, career planning is one major and significant factor. That's why career planning becomes necessity in this new era education. And then I would like to know the second question from you. Current practices, how we are doing career plannings right now? Aajkal kya chal raha hai? मतलब करियर प्लानिंग अभी तक कैसे हुई, हमारे टाइम पे कैसे हुई, या आपको क्या लगता है कि आजकल जो करियर प्लानिंग, जो प्रिवेलेंट करियर प्लानिंग है, व्हाटएवर इज प्रिवेलेंट प्रैक्टिस इन करियर प्लानिंग, सो व्हाट इज दैट? आई वुड लाइक टू नो फ्रॉम यू पीपल. आप में से एक एक दो दो टॉपिक आप बता सकते हैं. यस प्लीज प्लीज डू लिटिल इंटरेक्शन. यस सतीश चंद्र.
यस सर, अगर मैं बात करूं. यस सर
जी.
इफ आई टॉक टू अबाउट माई सेल्फ, देर वॉज नो करियर प्लानिंग एट दैट टाइम. माई पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो नॉट वेरी एजुकेटेड, एंड एट दैट टाइम टीचर्स आर ऑल्सो नॉट सो कीन टू टेल अबाउट समथिंग अबाउट द करियर. सो दैट वॉज अ वेरी टिपिकल टास्क. जैसे मैथ्स मैट्रिक मेरी बहुत अच्छी थी, लेकिन क्या हुआ, टेंथ के बाद में फिर एक मन हुआ कि नहीं साहब जो है डॉक्टर बनना है, पेरेंट्स की ऐसी इच्छा थी. तो जाकर के बायोलॉजी ले ली, लेकिन वो प्रॉपर नहीं कर पाए तो मैथ्स में मैं कर लेता. तो दैट टाइम देयर वाज नो प्रॉपर करियर प्लानिंग, और इसी वजह से मैं और इस सेशन को ज्वाइन किया. मैं काफी हमेशा अपने बच्चों में, स्टूडेंट्स में एंगेज रहता हूँ उस मामले में, और कई मैनी टाइम्स बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जिनके बारे में मैं इकट्ठा करके उनको बताता रहता हूँ.
वेरी गुड.
न्यू इरा में क्या है कि बहुत सारे ऑप्शंस आर देयर
जी,
वेरी वेरी आर ऑप्शंस, वेरी न्यू ऑप्शंस आर देयर. अब है क्या कि पुराने जो पेरेंट्स हैं हमारे, वो सब पुरानी ओल्ड थिंग्स के लिए, ओल्ड कोर्सेज के लिए जानते हैं, नए के लिए नहीं जानते हैं कि क्या करना है क्या नहीं. तो मेरे ख्याल से बच्चे के साथ साथ में दिस इज मस्ट, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द कैरियर प्लानिंग. गार्जियन मस्ट बी इंक्लूडेड इन दिस केस.
वेरी गुड.
क्योंकि इस केस में गार्जियंस को भी इंक्लूड करना चाहिए.
बहुत बढ़िया सर. सतीश जी आपके तरफ से बहुत बढ़िया इनपुट. आई क्लैप फॉर योर दिस एक्चुअली जेन्युइन इनपुट.
थैंक यू. थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू. यस, और हमें से और भी देना चाहता है. राधा मैम, वुड यू लाइक टू ऐड समथिंग हियर?
आई एग्री विद व्हाट सर सेड, इज दैट इन आवर टाइम नोबडी वाज दैट हेल्प अस टू प्लान आवर करियर. व्हाटएवर कम्स ऑन आवर वे वी वर डूइंग.
यू आर एब्सोल्युटली राइट. थैंक यू. थैंक यू. थैंक्स अ लॉट. यस, एनीबॉडी एल्स वुड लाइक टू ऐड समथिंग हियर? No, not at all.
I feel earlier the career used to be decided on the external influence, right? So there used to be three major areas.
Oh, sir, iska ek chiz to ja. Hello, hello, sir.
Hello.
Yes, please, Kavita ji, you continue, sir. आप इसके बाद please आप कर लेंगे अपना. Kavita ji, please continue. Harvinder ji, आपका number उसके बाद आने वाला है. Yes, please.
So the students who are very good, who are excellent, I mean, they should take science. Who are mediocre should go to commerce, and who are below average should go to arts. I think this was the criteria earlier, where, you know, without looking into ki the person really has any interest into that area or not. I think the careers used to be decided like that, and there were very limited number of careers, so hardly much choices were available. So major thing was doctor and engineer, or teacher, or for bank. I think these were the careers during our time, which, you know, and just basis on your marks, if you scored fantastically well, you should take science, irrespective of you may be having interest into commerce side or maybe into art side.
Good. Thank you, Kavita ji. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Just to heading the light on this topic, and it was a great brainstorming by everyone here. Yes, Harvinder ji, please, your turn is now.
Yes, sir. Just a point main isme extra add karunga. Jaisa ki dusre participant log bataye, intelligent students go to engineering, medical, next category in commerce and next in arts. And ek tarah se ye trend bhi tha ki jo bacche tez hain, lekin ab bacche tez hain lekin unka kuch interest ho bhi sakta hai jis par focus nahi hota tha, ek tarah se lakeer ki fakir ki taraf, okay, aur ye bahut tez hai, isko engineer banna hai, doctor banna hai, is tarah se chalte raha. Matlab usme kuch skill based identification and uska career allotment ka system bahut kam raha, aur aaj bhi ek tarah se situation wahi hai. Ek group, एक ट्रेंड बना हुआ है इंजीनियरिंग मेडिकल और ये जाना है इसमें, लेकिन अब हाई टाइम है इसको एक स्किलफुल पैटर्न पर ले जाने की जरूरत है, जिसमें ये करियर प्रैक्टिस और करियर काउंसलिंग, करियर गाइडेंस की बहुत जरूरत है. जिसके चलते मेरा कहने का मतलब है कि ये नहीं होने के कारण बहुत सारे चीजें छूट जा रही, जैसे सही जगह पर सही टैलेंट नहीं मिल पा रहा है. यस,
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू अरविंद जी, थैंक यू. आप सबने पूरी तरह टॉपिक को टाइट किया, यानी जहां जहां से निकल सकता था वो आपने सारे एस्पेक्ट्स को इकट्ठा किया. थैंक यू, थैंक्स अ लॉट एवरीवन, जस्ट टू मेक दिस टॉपिक वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड. Current practices are poor career planning. In the country, there is a very poor career planning of the students. So this is a very significant and viral issue in our education. And students opt career options out of known 07 options only. 7 option country mein hai, jisme se zyadatar bachche choose kar rahe hain. That is medical, engineering, computers, law, design, and finance and banking. So these are the 7-8 options. Out of these 7-8 options, students are going on these pathways only. Kota, Sikar, Jaipur, Delhi is full of the students, and the parents are putting their hard money on the preparation of that, and competition is becoming high, and density of the students on those particular paths is becoming high. And this way, students are not so happy. They are not on the right tracks. Ye badi ek problem hai. And fascination is in trend. Kisi ko dekh ke mujhe banna hai. So somebody went in IAS, then I also will go there. Or my kids should also go for IAS or PCS somewhere. And if somebody is earning a big package in a big company, then my child should also go over there, or the child also should get fascinated. Main bhaiya jaise banunga, ya main didi jaise kaam karungi. To wo fascination trend mein hai, kisi ko dekh ke career bacche choose kar rahe hain, ya parents usko choose kara rahe hain. Parents ka aur relatives ka influence hai. There is an influence of parents and relatives. It's external influence, because child is just a clay. He or she is not able to decide in which direction he or she should go. And because parents know it and parents apply sometimes, and majority of the parents, it is in the practice. Majority of the parents, and this is not a sin. Whatever I could not do, I will try to get it done from my son or my daughter. Jo main nahi kar saka, wo mera bachcha kare. So this is the actually trained. And this is not a sin, but this is a mismatch. Child can do something else better than whatever you are suggesting or you are putting him or her in that particular field. So ye abhi tak trend mein hai, and the academic scores decide the way for future study. As Kavita ji has added, if the child got good marks, good score in 10th class, then he or she will go to opt science. And if the score is not so good, school will not allow to take him or her in science batch. Commerce will be offered over there, and the parents will also go with her or him. And if the grades are not so good, then the child has no option than humanity. So that is the trend, which is actually not correct. That is the trend. Why it is not correct? So what becomes the result of this trend? Is trend ka result ye hai. So there is a big crowd on popular handful career paths. Wo jo medical, engineering, law, design, and chartered accountancy. So in those particular fields and those particular paths, there is a big crowd. And students, like there are 11, 12 lakhs participants, aspirants are appearing in civil services examination. There is only 1,000 are required there. So after 1,000, 10 lakhs, 99,000, where will they go? They have no second option with them. They just have targeted the thing that we will go to the civil services examination. Then if they could not select it over, what will they do? They will feel failure. They will feel dissatisfied. They will feel low, and they will search something for them. Whatever they want for them, they will not get it. And whatever they will get it, they will not like that. And this way, unemployment will spread it over, because whatever for what they have prepared, that is not available to do for them. And what is available to do, jo karne ke liye hai, that skill they do not possess. Jo unhone taiyari ki thi, wo kaam unko milega nahi. So there will be a complete mismatch of demand and supply, and due to that, they will face a big unemployment scenario in the market. And due to that, they will feel dissatisfied, because whatever they will get to do, that will not satisfy their soul and mind. And this way, their whole life will go in and under struggle, and they will feel failures for them. And this will lower down their confidence, and they will feel insecurity. They will not get whatever they want for them. वो जो अपने लिए चाहते हैं वो उनको वहां नहीं मिलेगा, और इस वजह से उनके लिए ये एक बड़ी प्रॉब्लम उन बच्चों को होने वाली है, और एक दो को नहीं, अकेले सिविल सर्विसेज में 11 लाख बच्चों को होने वाली है. तो आप सोच सकते हैं कि बाकी फिगर्स में बाकी पाथ्स पर क्या होगा. एंड नो इन्फॉर्म्ड और प्लान प्रिपरेशन. सो देयर इज नो इन्फॉर्म्ड और प्लान प्रिपरेशन. एंड टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया सेज that due to lack of this proper guidance, there is no proper guidance, no proper career planning. This is making youth choose life of crime too. Desh mein apradh ka bhi ek karan hai. So this is the result of not having proper career planning, and this becomes the need of our. And for that, you can see the facts and states here. That India Today says 93% Indian students aware of just 7 career options. What are parents doing wrong? Sirf engineering 23%, accounts and finance 11%, then computer is the choice 10%, and medicine 8%, management 6.7%, designing 6%, and law 4%, and rest all have nothing in their mind. सिर्फ 7 ऑप्शंस पर पूरा देश टिका है, इन्हीं तरफ भाग रहा है. एंड अदर इंडिया इज इन डायर नीड ऑफ 1.4 मिलियन करियर काउंसलर्स फॉर स्टूडेंट्स, बिकॉज स्टूडेंट्स आर नॉट गेटिंग काउंसलिंग. सो वन सर्वे ऑफ IC3 सेज दैट इंडिया हैज 350 मिलियन स्टूडेंट्स, द बिगेस्ट स्टूडेंट पॉपुलेशन इन द वर्ल्ड, बिगेस्ट स्टूडेंट पॉपुलेशन. एंड दिस पॉपुलेशन नीड at least 1.4 million career counselors. Why? Because so far, out of 50,000, only one child is connecting with the career counselors, professional career counselors, out of 50,000. 50,000 mein se ek bachche ko career planning ho rahi hai, career counselor mil raha hai. You can see how much difference is there and what is the scope of business and service over there. Aaj hum teachers, principals yahan isliye jude hain, because just doing whatever you are doing in your profession or career, do add this skill with yourself so that you can serve more, earn more, and earn knowledge and expertise also to give it to the society and to enable your own kids. अपने बच्चों को सफल बनाने के लिए, सोसाइटी में अच्छा कंट्रीब्यूशन देने के लिए, पैसा कमाने के लिए एक बहुत बड़ा मौका हमारे पास है. यस जसपाल जी, द सेशन इज गेटिंग रिकॉर्डेड एंड यू कैन हैव द रिकॉर्डिंग ऑफ दिस. सो रादर देयर इज नो सो मच बीइंग कंप्लीटेड एंड वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. सो अ लॉट ऑफ स्कोप ऑफ दिस करियर काउंसलिंग इज देयर. And there is one more fact, a World Economic Forum reports that 44% of students in India need career counseling. 44%, rather I will say 94%, because this forum could not reach to the rural students. And there is a big number in the rural and countryside in India. So there is 94% of students in India need career counseling. And this is the most important factor in demand supply mismatch. 93% of Indian schools do not have counselors. Oh my God, what is a big difference? The recent skilling report by Michael and Shoshan Dell Foundation states that only 1 out of 10 students in India receive career guidance. And this figure is also not correct. This is 1 of 10 of the very highly good schools. The result is 77% dropout among students at secondary school education. 77% secondary education par hi drop karte hain. And 250 million young population of India need career guidance, but the current schooling system doesn't provide it. So there is another survey. There is an absolute gap in providing career guidance to students at early age of education in school. Koi nahi batata. Hum jab aaj tak padhe, kisi ne nahi bataya aapko banna kya hai. बस ऐसे ही अंधे रास्ते पर पढ़ते गए. एंड द करेंट रेशियो ऑफ काउंसलर्स टू स्टूडेंट इज 50,000:1. 50,000 पर एक बच्चे एक काउंसलर है. आप सोच सकते हैं कितना बड़ा गैप है एंड कितना बड़ा स्कोप है, अपॉर्चुनिटी है आपके लिए. एंड देन व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ दिस? इंक्रीज्ड चांसेस एंड प्रोबेबिलिटी टू गेट सक्सेस. करियर प्लानिंग होने से, करियर गाइडेंस मिलने से, करियर काउंसलिंग होने से एक बच्चे की सक्सेस होने की प्रोबेबिलिटी और चांस बढ़ जाते हैं. एंड चाइल्ड गेट्स कॉन्फिडेंस, इंक्रीज फोकस इन स्टडी. व्हाई? बिकॉज नाउ देयर इज ए पर्पस ऑफ स्टडी. पर्पस, इफ देयर इज अ प्लान्ड करियर ऑलरेडी, द गोल इज डिफाइंड क्लियरली, देन चाइल्ड इज डूइंग एकेडमिक preparation, study, then he or she has a goal. And when he or she is just taking the steps on the path to achieve the goal, the confidence increase, gets start to increase, and the whole energy, time, and efforts toward, aligns towards that pathway and that goal. Us pathway aur us goal par uske sare ke sare एफर्ट्स लगने शुरू हो जाते हैं. जस्ट अ मिनट प्लीज, होल्ड फॉर माइ. सो दिस वे द फोकस गेट्स इंक्रीज्ड. एंड बिकॉज नाउ इफ देयर इज अ करियर प्लानिंग, then the study has a purpose. But without the career planning, there is no necessity that there is a goal of it. So those all energies align nahi hoti. It makes aware of career opportunities and priorities in advance. It increases job satisfaction, studied satisfaction. When the child plan the career with open eyes, with open senses, then at that path, if that child gets job, when he becomes employee or the business person, then he or she gets satisfaction. Whatever he or she wanted and she or he is getting now. So that is the satisfaction, and life goes at the good path. And career according to your, if this is a career according to your interests and accomplishments, then it becomes good with the people, with those students when they become employable. And opportunity for teachers, what are the opportunity for we teachers over there? And it doesn't matter in what age we are. It doesn't matter what subject we are teaching. It doesn't matter at what position we are. It doesn't matter in which type of school we are. So this can be a good opportunity to everyone. And it doesn't matter even if you have not studied psychology. No, not at all. Agar aapne psychology nahi bhi padhi, then also you can become a career counselor. Then also. Because there is a big requirement in the country. So now all of a sudden, those psychologists cannot come out of this schools and become career counselors. So there is a big gap. Those who are very empathic person, those who can solve the problem of others, those who can listen the problem of students, they can become career counselors. So what is the opportunity for teachers? Like Radha ma'am, you are going to retire now. At this moment, you are a package of knowledge and expertise because you have worked for so many years in schools. And now you can start this, just guiding students from your home. You can start this doing at online because I'm doing this online. Before this COVID, so I was just connecting with the students. I was just flying and just moving to the different parts of the country, hold the air. But now we are stationed at a place and we are just doing this career counseling one-on-one on the Zoom and the team. And it is possible. It is happening. Parents and students are changing us to get the career counseling of themselves or their kids. So what is the opportunity for teachers? Teachers have big opportunity to become career counselors, and it is not necessary to have degrees in psychology. You can learn this and start practicing. However, it would be added advantage to get a diploma in career guidance in case you get it. And what would be the benefit of this to the teachers? Just open your eyes. The second line on your screen can open your mind and eyes really. It is highly paying job and can be done part-time. Highly paying job. Achha dhan kama sakte ho part-time. How? It pays rupees 3,000 to 1,50,000 per child. Oh my God. Isn't that a big lie? No, not at all. My co-counselors, I mean my fellow counselors, my so many counselors are there. Those who are just helping students to plan their career to go abroad, they are charging 1,50,000 per application, per child. And those who are performing for the domestic students for the Indian states, so they are charging 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, 6,000, 10,000, 15,000. It depends upon your expertise and how much value you are adding to the students, how much clarity you are giving to them, how efficiently you are convincing them and making their pathways easily with your expertise. It depends upon that, what exactly you are giving. And there is no any fixed parameter that what you are going to charge. Koi parameter nahi hai. You can charge as you like, but remember, give the value. In case you are giving the value to the people, people will come to you. Why? That people have only one or two children nowadays, and they do not want to take risk of going in the dark. Bachchon ke bhavishya ko andhere mein bhejna koi nahi chahta. And they are making expenses of lakhs of the fees on their school fees, school expenses. And there is no big concern for them to pay one-time fee for career counseling. It is easy to them. But in case you could give them value, they will be happy paying you this amount and you will be happy to take this amount. So this is a very big option for teachers ke liye hai, ki hum yahan se career counseling ko apne jeevan mein agar part banaye, to ek achha amount kama sakte hain, achha naam kama sakte hain, achhi seva society ki kar sakte hain, part-time kar sakte hain, online kar sakte hain. It is not necessary you do it going somewhere. People will come to you directly. So in case you have any questions so far, you can ask it now. Aap mein se kisi ka koi sawal ho, aap pooch sakte hain. Is there any question so far? No, not at all. So let's move ahead. चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं. जी
हेलो सर.
जी
हेलो सर.
जी
हाँ सर, अभी आपने कुछ बताया था कि पीजी डिप्लोमा कोर्स, ये इसका कुछ डिटेल बताते.
हाँ, इसके लिए अगर आपने साइकोलॉजी नहीं पढ़ी, साइकोलॉजिस्ट बनने के लिए आपने बैचलर किसी में भी किया, एक तरीका है कि आप मास्टर्स कर सकते हैं साइकोलॉजी में, आप डिस्टेंस से करें, रेगुलर करें. दूसरा तरीका है कि ट्वेल्थ करने के बाद भी, मतलब ग्रेजुएशन कर लिया, बहुत अच्छी बात है, ग्रेजुएशन कर लिया तो एक एडिटेड एडवांटेज है और सारे टीचर्स ग्रेजुएशन तो लगभग है ही, उसके बाद करियर गाइडेंस एंड काउंसलिंग में एक डिप्लोमा होता है, एक साल का भी है, दो साल का भी है, और वो इग्नू में है, जामिया मिलिया में है और इंडिया में कई यूनिवर्सिटीज में है. आप उसके लिए अप्लाई कर सकते हो. और ये जी
डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन कोर्स.
पार्डन,
डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन कोर्स, करियर काउंसलिंग कोर्स,
बेसिक एजुकेशन फॉर दिस
डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन ऑनलाइन.
या इट्स अवेलेबल ऑनलाइन. या सो यू जस्ट हैव टू गो फॉर वन मंथ ओवर देयर. One or two months would be required to go over there for physical classes. So this would not be 100% online. It would be approximate 80 to 90% online. So for some of the practical sessions, you have to go over there. Otherwise, it is possible. So I can give you the names of the universities, those who are just giving such kind of courses. Any more question, please?
हाँ सर, बिना कोर्स का कुछ प्लान है इसमें?
या
बिना
कोर्स के भी आप करियर प्लानिंग आप शुरू कर सकते हो. सो यू कैन जस्ट स्टार्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस, बट इफ यू डू दिस कोर्स देन इट वुड बी अ वेरी गुड एडवांटेज, बिकॉज समटाइम्स पीपल कम ओवर देयर. जब पेरेंट्स आपके पास आते हैं और किसी ने पूछ लिया तो फिर आपको एक वैल्यू सर्टिफिकेट होना चाहिए, अदरवाइज यू कैन प्रैक्टिस इट. देयर इज नो नेसेसिटी ऑफ दिस. अ लॉट ऑफ माय फेलोज आर प्रैक्टिसिंग दिस विदाउट their diplomas and degrees, and they are doing it fantastically. Some of them who are very, very keen to do it, they are doing it fantastically. It is not necessary. It depends upon how keen you are learning these things and giving it back to the people.
नहीं, यही बात मैं पूछ रहा हूँ सर, तो इसका लर्निंग का क्या पैटर्न है और कहाँ से लर्न किया जाए उसको?
Yes, वो मैं आपको अभी कवर करूंगा. I'll just cover it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
And what would be the role of teachers in career planning? The role will be, they will be helping the students to do their self-assessment. Now, a new thing is coming in the picture now, self-assessment. So career planning is connected with the assessment. It cannot go beyond assessment, identifying, recognizing a student. So teachers can help them to do their self-assessment. So teachers can conduct assessment of the students and they can help students to do their self-assessment. That is the one aspect. And second is teachers can help them to explore wide career options. A teacher can give other career options also. Teacher can provide a lot of options which actually the students and parents are not aware of. दुनिया में बहुत सारे options हैं, but parents और students के पास वो knowledge नहीं है. तो teacher can study it and can put in front of them just to choose out of them for them whatever they feel sweet fit for them. And the teacher can help them to make informed career choices. Informed means सोच समझ के पहले ही, in advance. Just aligning all the things together, just working on all the factors together, and then making career choices based upon the best match. Whatever they have, according to that, whatever is possible in the market for them, and just making the match of that. So, teacher can help to decide this for a student and then help them to decide it. And demystifying the confusion related to career pathway. Students are just confused. Jaspal ji, aapka mic bilkul sound nahi hai. Please.
Gurubar ko CDS General Rawat sabhi 13 logon ke shab liye ambulance Wellington se Surur ke liye
जसपाल जी आपके माइक से आवाज बहुत क्रैक होके आ रही है, यू कैन राइट इट इन द चैट बॉक्स. एंड टीचर्स कैन एक्ट एज नेविगेटर्स, टीचर्स कैन एक्ट एज गाइड, टीचर्स कैन एक्ट एज कैटलिस्ट फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स एक्चुअली. तो टीचर्स का रोल इसमें बहुत बड़ा है एंड पेरेंट्स का रोल भी इसमें इतना बड़ा है कि इन दिस वर्ल्ड ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन द स्टूडेंट्स शुड नॉट गो ऑन स्टडी द वे वी वेंट. Because if I talk about myself, then I made some decisions when I was studying class 10th. And then I decided four careers for myself based upon nothing. And I was just following those four things for last 20 years. मैं पिछले 20 साल से उन चीजों को follow करता रहा. Then I came to know that my right fit career is guiding others, making them enable, and I could not recognize this in the 20 years my career. And I went in every career, I tested 13 different careers. Then I came to know, and I spent my golden time 20 years just because of I could not do it prior to my academic studies, academic learnings, academic performance. अगर वो पहले होता तो मुझे 20 साल नहीं खर्च करने पड़ते. तो ऐसे ही हमारे टाइम पर जो हुआ वो अब नहीं हो, तो पेरेंट्स इसके लिए सही टाइम पर डिसीजन लें. क्या डिसीजन लें? इट स्टार्ट्स आफ्टर 7th स्टैंडर्ड एंटिल 9th स्टैंडर्ड. बिटवीन 7th एंड 9th, rather 8th एंड 9th, दिस आर द बिगनिंग ईयर्स. During 8th and 9th standard, the student, the child should complete the exploration of career options. What are the career options in the entire world or in this country? Just the child should study all those career options. He or she should explore that what career options are available for him or her. Ye puri duniya, and in the market, which is the career which is in demand? And what is the demand of market? What are the current trend in the market? So this is required to understand by them, and parents can help them to do this. And second thing, assessment. The parents should help the students to have assessment to know their innate talent and skills, their abilities and their interest. So after half of the year 9th, when is the time of this assessment? After 8th class, when the student has studied something in 9th, because some of the syllabus is required to be covered of the 9th class. So when the child come in the 9th and before 10th examination, when the child writes examination for 10th, the child should be assessed for career planning. So that is required by the parents. The parents cannot do assessment themselves because this is a very technical and scientific kind of process. And they also might not have answers of all the questions. So they can connect the child with a professional career counselor who can answer the questions for that particular child or who can do assessment of that child. So parents are required to do this. And then parents required to narrow down the list of options and priorities based upon that assessment, because child has studied a wide options of career during 8th and 9th, might be 100 or 200, then he will be lost in those career options. Now, based upon assessment, a career counselor can just guide and recommend that you should go in one or two careers pathways. Then the parents should help them to understand more and more about those career pathways, those recommended career pathways, and then help them to fix the goal in those pathways. Just pathways have been recommended by the career counselor, then the child is required to make the goals for himself or herself, and parents should help them to do this. And parents should connect them to the professionals of that particular pathway the student is deciding for himself or herself. जैसे किसी को सिविल सर्विसेज में जाना है तो वो सिविल सर्वेंट से, सिविल ऑफिसर से, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर से बच्चे को मिलवाए, उसे पूछे कि वो कैसे बने, क्या मुश्किलें उनको हुई और वो उनको करना क्या पड़ता है, उसके चैलेंजेस क्या है, उसके बेनिफिट्स क्या है. सो दिस शुड ऑल्सो बी फैसिलिटेटेड बाय द पेरेंट्स टू द स्टूडेंट्स इन टाइम. सिर्फ फैसिनेशन में कोई करियर प्लान बच्चा ना करे. आई थिंक दिस इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. यहां तक सबको क्लियर है रोल ऑफ पेरेंट्स, रोल ऑफ टीचर्स and opportunities for the teachers. I think that is clear to everyone. In case you have any questions so far, you can ask it now. No, then let's move ahead. There is a spelling mistake in this process, so don't worry about that. So science and process of career planning now, what is exactly this process and how teachers can do this, can make this as a part of their job, as a part of their career, as a second thing for their earning. कैसे वो कर सकते हैं, what are its stages, let's learn this process now. So ये असली process है. In case you have pen and paper with you, just keep noting this, and whenever you think that you are not able to take something, you can stop me, I'll answer all your questions and queries. आप मुझे पूछते जाएंगे, मैं आपको समझाता जाऊंगा. Career counseling stages, there are 5 stages of career counseling. The first stage is self-assessment. The child should know himself or herself. The career counselor should know the child from inside. The parent should know the child actually from inside. Self-assessment helps a child, counselor and parents to know about the child better way. And after self-assessment, the child is required to explore available career options on the earth for him or her. All those career options. Now, in one bucket, in one basket, there are approximate 500 career options. And the assessment says you can do 5-10 works better than others. Now, out of those 500, child will pick 5-10, and out of those 5-10, the child will make a decision to go with one as a first and primary career choice and second as a backup choice. That is the third stage. And on the fourth stage, the child will be requiring to design the pathway that if I go for civil services or medical or engineering or law or design or liberal science or actuary somewhere, then what would be my pathway? What should I take after 10th? What should I opt after 12th? What course I should study after 12th? And which would be the college for it? How I will take the admission in that particular college? How much fees I would require to pay to that particular college? And how much probability I have to get admission over there. If that college is not able to, or I would not be able to take admission in that particular college, what could I do? What are other options over there? And if I get admission, then how much fees would be required? So actually my parents would be able to bear this fees. If not, then from where I can get help in the form of a scholarship? That also is required to design in the advance to get a success in career. That's a part of career planning, pathway designing. And after pathway designing, help and support to take actions by the students. Students will start taking support. Whenever he or she will be taking decisions, he will require somebody to guide him or her, and parents also. So the career counselor will remain over there to support and help them to move ahead, to provide the necessary information. These are the 5 stages of career counseling, and these 5 stages career counseling will be done by a career counselor, and you teacher can do it very well way. I think this is clear to everyone. In case you have any question in this particular slide, you can ask, please. No question? Very good. Chaliye, next. So the next step is student assessment and its relevance. What is assessment and what is its relevance with the career planning? So student assessment is actually, it is required to assess three things. The one, aptitude. Aptitude means abilities which will help the child in the future as a strength. Aptitude is ability which will be helpful to the student in that particular career he is going to choose. So what you are good at is called aptitude. Aptitude means cognitive aptitudes. And personality, how the child is grooming or developing. So whatever personality, physical or mental personality is getting developed of that child is actually matters in the career planning. And third is inclination, interest. What child think, what child like, liking, loving, passion, hobbies, those all things come in this interest field. So if these three things are recognized, known well, genuinely, then it becomes easy to a child to make a career decision. How this happens? So there are so much branches of science by which you can know this all. Means psychology has such kind of research, such kind of tools and techniques by which abilities, means cognitive abilities, personality factors and interest can be identified and recognized while way. So John Holland has studied and prepared one Rysack formula, and based upon John Holland's Rysack formula, this is the Rysack formula. It actually has a questionnaire, and through that particular questionnaire, if students just answer genuinely, then the interest of the student can be known easily. And the same way, there are two more formulas. One is CHC formula. CHC, that is Kettle-Horn-Carroll theory. This was a research from 1941 to 2010. This was approximately 70 years research in this particular field. Why which the it very easily the aptitude and ability of a child, cognitive abilities can be measured, and those ability, if measured properly, they can help a child to plan the career, to plan the career based upon. So that is the second technique and tool. And the third technique is Big Five theory, by which the personality factor is getting measured. So we have measured the innate abilities, we have measured the personality, which is the developed traits, and the inclination of the child. If those three things gets identified, then it becomes easy for a teacher, for a counselor, to know better about a child. And based upon the combination of these three things, it becomes easy for a counselor to guide and recommend in which career option he or she should go. Like this, I'm just going to demonstrate it. If the child is good at numerical aptitude, this is one of the aptitude CHC theory. Child is good at numerical aptitude, then the child can go in the IT, statistics, mathematics, finance, actuaries, banking. He will perform better in those particular areas. Then verbal aptitude, if a child is good communicating himself or understanding others, then he can be anchor, journalist, writer, author, politician. And if a child is good at mechanical kind of things, mechanical kind of abilities, child can be a good engineer, navy, pilot, fire specialist in the technical work. And if a child is good in thinking, this reasoning, cognitive power, he can be a lawyer, marketing personnel, marketing professional, sales professional, entrepreneur, scientist, finance professional. If a child is good at special aptitude, special means just figures, roads, mountains, shapes, Then he can be a designer, architect, engineer, sculptor, film director, animation, a specialist, designer, or pilot. So this is based upon aptitude. If the child is good at numerical, then he should go in this particular field, these particular fields. If the child is good at reasoning, then he should opt any one field out of this. The same way, personality factors and careers, in case we come to know, then there are five factors of personality. Experientials. So those who are experiential orientation children, they are good at finance, sales, marketing, actuaries, imaginative. Those who are imaginative, they can be artists, they can be filmmaker, actor, poet, writer, scientist. And interpersonal orientation, the child is quite intro or just extro. Then those who are intro, they can be writers, researcher, painting artist, accountant. Those who are extro, they can be a teacher, marketing and sales professional, politicians, public relations manager. And those who are emotional, emotionally, those who are strong, they can be doctor, firefighter, civil servant, army, defense manager, police, corporate administrator, education administrator, PR, security personnel. Those who are not strong, they can go to the society kind of work, social kind of works in NGOs, helping others. And attitudinal orientation, if the child is tough competitor, then he can go to the sales and marketing, finance and business. And if the child is not good, tough competitor, then he might be helpful to others. Then he should go to, he become a teacher, counselor, social worker, doctor, wherein society service is involved in the career. And the consciousness orientation, if a child is with conscious orientation, he can be successful in any of the career, because consciousness means organized. How much is organized a child in the personality, he will be able to manage in all the careers. This is the required and essential personality trait. And the third thing is interest factors. So out of six interests, Holland says the child would be good at two or three or one interest area. If a child is realistic, he should be engineer, architect, pilot, military officer, forester. If the child is investigative interest, then he can be an economist, lawyer, engineer, research analyst, psychologist, physician, surgeon. If a child has artistic inclination, then the child can be artist, singer, musician, actor, interior designer, writer, PR specialist, reporter, interior designer. And if a child has a social inclination to help others, inclination, interest, then the child can be a counselor, social worker, NGO worker, teacher, nurse, therapist. And if a child has an enterprising interest, just to commanding others, then he can be a manager, salesperson, marketing analyst, entrepreneur, recruiter. And if a child has a conventional kind of interest, whatever is happening for the last many years, that should go ahead. The child would not add anything from him or her side. Then he should be a banker, clerk, financial expert, data analyst, credit manager, wherein he or she has not to do creative something. Whatever is happening, whatever is written in the rule book, he or she has to follow. Then he should go to such kind of fields. So this way, if this could be identified in advance, then it becomes easy for a counselor or a teacher or parent to guide that in which particular field the child will or child should go to get success, because the abilities and the personality and interest parameters are just communicating that he or she should opt those areas wherein he will do better based upon those traits and will become happy and satisfied. So yahan tak ye teen cheeze sabko samajh mein aayi. In case you have any question, you can ask now, please. Aapko sabko samajh mein aaya? Good, thank you. Now, based upon career assessment, you will get the reports like that. Agar aapne career assessment kiya to report aise dikhai degi, jisme koi 10 career choices har bacche ko wahan nikal ke aati hai. 10 career choices aise nikal ke aayengi. Main aapko yahan dikha raha hu. Ek live dekhenge aap ki career choices kaise nikalti hai. I'm just going to show you. I'm showing you one report of career choices, which you will be able to identify and guess. Yes, so this is one of the assessment report, one of the child, Kavita Rakesh. You can see, aap dekh sakte hain, that this is the ability structure of this child, ability profile. As per ability profile, this child is good at verbal than others. So this is the big ability of this, and this can be used as a primary ability to decide a career for her. And the second, personality traits, this is normal because it is average, this is average, this is average, this is average, and this is quite introvert. Child is quite introvert, but verbal is good. She's good at writing, not verbal, she's good at writing. And the interest part, she's good at enterprising, she's good at realistic, and she's good at investigative. But she has no any artistic hand, very low in art, and conventional is also low, and social is quite average. Based upon these things, this girl is being recommended to opt these 10 areas. Out of these 10 areas, she can take one or two for her. Isme se wo apne liye ek ya do choose kar sakti hai, and these are the being analyzed. Those personality traits and abilities are analyzed, putting all together, and based upon that, the report is being generated. Iske basis par ye report generate hui hai. To ye hamara assessment, and this assessment is called psychometric assessment. Rather, there are too many tools to access the child. Bahut sare tools hain bacche ko access karne ke, but psychometric assessment is a good kind of tool. Rather, people are doing DMIT, but I will not suggest and recommend DMIT. DMIT has no so much scope. It has no ground to explain why DMIT is useful. So just checking the finger of a child, you cannot just identify that in which particular field he or she should go. So that is not a right way. The actually scientific way and the research way is psychometric assessment. There are multiple kind of psychometric assessment. You can choose anyone based upon its reliability and accuracy. Aap koi bhi ek test le sakte hain, jiske basis par aap bachchon ko test karna seekh sakte hain. To ye ek test tha jisme hum alag alag tarike ke career fitment analysis karke bachche ke, jaise ek jyotishi, ek astrologist, sun signs ko aur sun ki position, planets ki position ko calculate karke batata hai. The same way, the assessment says that what are the good things with the child, bacche ke paas kya achha hai, aur bacche ko kis field mein uske basis pe jana chahiye. So that was the step one, means assessment. Psychometric assessment is the ground and first step to move ahead in career planning, or to guide or counsel the children to do their informed career choices. Isme kisi ka koi question ho to please poochhein, otherwise we will go to the next and further step.
This psychometric assessment is a tool?
Yeah.
Is it a tool?
It's a tool, yeah. Psychometric assessment is a tool, and these tools are available online, and you can just, you have to buy this from some company, those who have developed it for themselves. Rather, there are some of them are free online, but they are not so much useful because you cannot check their reliability. So this should be reliable because you are going to guide lives based upon those recommendations. So the test should be very much reliable.
I had done one test like what you are telling now, the print of the palm.
Pardon?
Of the palm is being taken, palm.
Radha, ma'am, your voice is too low. It would be good in case you can put it in the chat box so that I can take it from there.
Okay.
Please. Okay, so then let's move ahead. Meanwhile, ma'am is putting the question over there. So second step is after assessment. Assessment says that child can go into those 10, 5 areas. It would be better for him or her to opt choice out of these 5, 10 areas based upon his or her abilities. Now, the choice is narrowed. Out of those career options, now he or she or the child will thinking about picking one or two options from those just packet or bunch or package of 5, 10 career choices. And the second step is to serve all those career options. So there are multiple career choices, not only 7 choices are there in India itself. So there are approximate 550 plus career choices. Out of those, there are 334 professional career pathways and 221 vocational career pathways. Out of those, child can opt any one or two for him or her. Whereas before starting this session, we were stuck on 7 career options only. Hum sirf 7 cheeze hamare paas thi, yani 7 options par duniya ja rahi thi. Aaj hamare paas 550 career options available hain. Bacche ko ye 550 career options agar pata chal jaye, उसमें से वो अपना करियर चूज करे बेस्ड अपॉन असेसमेंट, तो उसके सक्सेस होने के चांस ज्यादा बनते हैं. तो सेकंड स्टेप टीचर को क्या करना है, 550 करियर्स को स्टडी करना है. बहुत सिंपल है, इट इज कैटेगराइज्ड वेरी सिंपली. हाउ दिस इज कैटेगराइज्ड, यू कैन सी, आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू शो यू, सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन व्हाट आर दोज 550 करियर ऑप्शंस. सो एक्सप्लोर करियर्स. So this is mentioned online. Professional careers, 334 professional careers. So there are 21 career clusters we have created. And in each of the career cluster like agriculture, there are 10 career options. Through this agriculture and food science, the child can be agricultural biotechnologist, agriculture scientist, agronomist, animal scientist, dairy technologist, food scientist, plant scientist, horticulturalist, forestry professional, soil scientist. The same way, if a child goes to allied and paramedical, then in paramedical, oh my God, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 32 career options are there, 32. And then animation and graphics, there are 5 career options available professionally. Architecture and planning, 6. Art and design, oh my God, there are 15 career options. And in business management, there are again 15 career options. And in education and teaching, so there are 14 career options available. In engineering itself, there are 36 types of career. Oh my God, 36 types of career in engineering itself. Finance and banking, you can see there are 16 type of careers. The child just studying finance and banking, he can be accountant, banker, chartered accountant, economics, CMA, company secretary, finance manager, finance engineer, finance planning, investment banker, risk manager, and a lot. The same way, fitness, well-being, government and defense services, in government services, what a child can do. So there is a complete encyclopedia of this. Journalist, medical sciences, a child can go to the medical field and he can be like this 33 type of careers are there. And then sales and marketing, performing arts, science and mathematics. Apart from engineering and medical, there are a lot of options in science, pure science. So wherein the child who is studying medical or engineering, if he or she could not get selected, then he or she has no option, no vision, what she or he should do. So he or she should be prepared with the this pure science option in advance. Then if they could not get the chance to get in medical or engineering, they can go to these fields. A lot of fields are available in the pure science too. And the same way, vocational career, you can see in vocational career itself, apart from professional, there are multiple ways to go based upon certificate courses, diploma courses, not any degree course. Aise karke yahan bahut sare vocational or professional career hain. जिनको अगर स्टडी एक टीचर कर लें तो उनके लिए बड़ा आसान बन जाता है कि वो उस करियर में उस बच्चे को गाइड कर सके. लेट्स मूव अहेड वन मोर स्टेप अहेड टू द नेक्स्ट स्टेप 3. इन द थर्ड स्टेप करियर पाथवे मैपिंग एंड रिकमेंडेशन. करियर पाथवे मैपिंग व्हाट वी शुड डू व्हाट अ टीचर कैन डू. करियर ऑप्शन 1, बैकअप ऑप्शन 2, व्हाट आफ्टर 10th, व्हाट शुड अ चाइल्ड टेक आफ्टर 10th. द पेरेंट्स एंड टीचर बोथ कैन टेक दिस डिसीजन और इन द फॉर्म ऑफ करियर काउंसलर टीचर शुड सजेस्ट और रिकमेंड what is the career option 1 for that particular child based upon career assessment, and what is the option backup option 2 if a child could not get fitted in this career option 1, then immediately he or she should have something in the back pocket to opt in. And for that and to get success in this particular career pathway, what after 10th a child should take in the form of subjects, what after 12th, what course he or she should choose to study further, and in which college he or she should take admission, and how to take admission, whether it is entrance admission or on the merit admission, and the fees. Yes. In the school, if there is no fee arrangement with the parents, then how the children will arrange scholarship to pay the fees. So these 7 steps are required to be recommended by the career counselor, or if you are a parent, then you have to have the answer of these 7 questions in the step 3, career pathways mapping and recommendation. And after that, informed career options. Informed means now the child is ready with the informed career option and pathway. So if the child is ready with this, then he will have answer what after 10th. And it doesn't matter what score he or she has. So in case the school A is not allowing admission, if the score is low and the school is not allowing admission in science, and if the child wants to study science, he can change the school. And if a child is good at sports and he wants to study humanity further, arts, so he can obtain. The same way, what after 12th, choosing educational pathway courses after 12th, what course the child should have, he or she should have that answer. So whether he'll go to the science, career options in pure science, physics, chemistry, mathematics, agriculture, biochemistry, bioinformatics, botany, biotechnology, career options in commerce, BCom, BCom honors, BA, BBM, BMS, BBE, BFIA, a lot of courses are there. And if he or she is in science, then medical, architecture, engineering, these are required to study. In pure science, these are the 8 subjects child can study. And in career options in commerce, the child can go for BCom, BCom honors, BBA, BBM, BBMS, BA, BBA, B5A. And then management courses, child can go to the management part of this. And professional courses are chartered accountant, this cost and management accountant. Actuary is a new thing in the market. CFA, financial accounting, auditing, finance, stockbroking, taxation, insurance, banking, a lot of options are there. And then humanities, arts, history and arts, political science, geography, psychology, anthropology, language, social work. Again, in psychology itself, there are 6 types of careers the child can choose. And apart from this science, commerce, arts, if a child has made a mistake, if a child has already opted the subject, then after 12th, he can choose the neutral career for him or her. He can change the career pathway, that neutral career, hotel management. If a child has studied humanity, commerce or arts or agriculture, anything in 11th and 12th, he can opt hotel management after 12th. Economics, liberal arts, design, law, media and entertainment, civil services, defense services, teaching, in these 9 areas, child can go even he or she has studied anything in 11th and 12th. So these are the neutral careers. Child can correct himself or herself. And the career pathway example would be like that. That for this particular child, we have recommended that the first career option will be vocation in defense, security, and government services. This child will, or this child can opt the career in defense, security, and government services like police, constable in Delhi police, territory police, BSF, CISF, because this is a vocational kind of assessment for this child. This child will not study further. Based upon the assessment, the child will not study further because the child comes from very poor background. So he or she would require a professional, not professional career, vocational career. Then the first career option would be like that. And you as a teacher will guide like this. And the second option will be backup career option, textile and handloom, vocational junior engineer in textile sector. So you can see, I'm just going to show you the report of this child. And just based upon this report, you can see textile and handloom is the option one. But child comes from a poor background. So we would not give her directly to study further. Rather, there is a defense, security, and government services. And if she prepares herself for this, then she can go to the defense services or police services somewhere. And then she can pursue the study further to go in textile or in any other field. So this would be the option one. And this is the recommendation by the career counselor that he or she is not taking textile as a first option, because as per the family background, so she would be requiring to go in the job directly after 10. So she can be recommended with the defense, security, and government services as a career option one, and the backup plan, textile and handloom. So this way, you came to know that how to recommend the career option one, and then backup career option, textile and handloom, vocational junior engineer, study in the textile sector. What after 10th? Preparation for recruitment test for state police, Delhi, army, BSF, CISF, territory police. तो ये बच्ची को 10वीं के बाद क्या करना चाहिए, प्रिपरेशन करनी चाहिए पुलिस में जाने का, या BSF, CISF, टेरिटरी में एज ए कॉन्स्टेबल वहां भर्ती हो सकती है. सेकेंड, meanwhile, she can take admission in polytechnic engineering diploma in textile fashion designing in Delhi, because she belongs to Delhi. And college to study polytechnic engineering diploma in Delhi. So that is also required to recommend. International Polytechnic for Women has two courses, full-time diploma in fashion designing, full-time diploma in textile designing. So she can go for it. And the second college of polytechnic in Delhi is, which is having this course, full-time diploma in printing technology. That's a Pusa Institute of Technology. Only two colleges are there, government colleges are there, who can give this type of admission to this child over there. And admission would be based upon entrance test, and the forms comes online in July and August. So child should remain aware, and where to apply? Child has to apply online at this particular site, desu.ac.in. So child has just received the everything information about career and what fees would be required to qualify this exam. 50,000 rupees for 3 years. First year 15,000, second year 16,500, third year 18,500. And if the family is not able to bear this fees too, then scholarship is available in that particular college only from e-district portal, Toppers Scholarships, and from Mahindra Scholarship Program. So she can apply online to these scholarships to study further. Now, everything is clear here. You can see, based upon assessment, based upon career exploration, based upon perfect match between two available options and recommended options, the child took two options based upon the family background and assessment and availability of the courses in the Delhi itself. So she could get two options over there. And now which course she should opt now, which college she should go, and how the admission will be happening over there, and when she should apply for this, what will be the website online wherein she would be required to apply. And then if the family is not able to pay the fees, where she should apply to get scholarship. Everything is clear, very well way, crystal way. Now the child will get the direction to move ahead. She has a goal that I'll go to the forces. And meanwhile, during preparing my forces, I'll not just waste my time. I'll take admission in Polytechnical Engineering too. So in case before completing this Polytechnical Engineering, Diploma Engineering, if I could placed in forces, I'll go straight way over there. Otherwise, I'll continue my studies this way so that I can become a textile engineer through Delhi only, because being a girl, she cannot move ahead and the family will not allow, and family is not economically so strong. So the girl will study this all in Delhi itself, or ye sara ka sara uske samne ek informed career choices ki form mein uski career planning ho gayi. तो ये बहुत आसान हो सकता है आप सबके लिए, जैसे मैंने यहाँ उसके लिए प्लान किया. असेसमेंट और आपकी करियर प्लानिंग, करियर चॉइसेस की जो लर्निंग है, अगर आपने वो दो चार पांच बार कर ली तो ये आपके लिए बड़ा आसान हो जाएगा कि इस तरह किसी बच्चे का करियर पाथवे डिजाइन कर सकें, और फिर वो बच्चा अपनी सारी एनर्जी, सारा फोकस उसी रास्ते पर लगाएगा, क्योंकि अब उसके पास इसके लिए एक रास्ता है, एक गोल है, एक लक्ष्य है, एक पाथ है. अब पढ़ाई करने में उस बच्चे का मन लगेगा और बड़े जोश से उस रास्ते के कंपटीशन को वो जीत जाएगा. आई थिंक अब आप सबको इसमें क्लियर हुआ. आपके कोई क्वेश्चन हो प्लीज इसमें तो पूछ सकते हैं. नॉट एट ऑल. ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड. अब आप कैसे स्टार्ट करेंगे इसको? किसी ने क्वेश्चन, हरविंदर जी ने क्वेश्चन पूछा था कि हम टीचर्स उसे कैसे स्टार्ट कर सकते हैं, हाउ वी टीचर्स कैन मूव अहेड. सो यू वुड रिक्वायर टू गेट ट्रेनिंग फ्रॉम एनी रेपुटेड करियर काउंसलिंग कंपनी. दैट इज वन ऑप्शन. अदरवाइज यू कैन लर्न इट अंडर एन एक्सपीरियंस्ड करियर काउंसलर. सो जस्ट फॉर 2-3-4 टाइम्स इन केस यू कुड लर्न इट, यू विल बिकम टू डू इट इंडिपेंडेंटली. सेकेंड, स्टार्ट स्टडीइंग एंड लर्निंग करियर ऑप्शंस बैंक. What career options are available? What are the professional career options? What are vocational career options? And the third is start learning assessment. How assessment you can do, how it happens, what you should take as a precaution, and how you have to measure the findings, how you have to interpret the result. So that you require to learn, and get on the job training. Just start doing counseling under any just experienced career counselor, and do the homework, do the groundwork for him or her for first 5-10 counseling, and then you start doing it itself. And then start doing assessment and career counseling independently. This can be done easily. In case any one of us is just want to start this journey, then they can connect me over my phone tomorrow onwards. So I can just guide them to become this. And there is no so much investment. You can do it very at very handful cost. You would not be requiring to put a lot of your hard money over there. You just start learning, and there is no so much expenses of this. So those who are interested, they can just call me tomorrow morning. The number you can see, this is written over there on the back of myself. यहां से आप नंबर ले सकते हैं, और आप जिसको इंटरेस्ट हो आप बात कर सकते हैं. पेरेंट्स की फॉर्म में आज अगर कोई यहाँ है और उनको अपने बच्चे के लिए करियर गाइडेंस चाहिए तो आप भी मुझे कनेक्ट कर सकते हैं. इसी के साथ आज का सेशन यहीं फिनिश होता है. आपके कोई क्वेश्चंस हो तो प्लीज आप पूछें. No questions. Thank you. Thanks a lot. आपका कोई फीडबैक हो आज के सेशन के लिए तो प्लीज आप दे सकते हैं इन केस
थैंक
यू राधा मैम थैंक यू थैंक्स अ लॉट यस सतीश जी
थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू थैंक्स अ लॉट सर थैंक यू कविता जी
यस रुकमान जी थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू कविता जी थैंक्स अ लॉट सो ग्रेट इन केस यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस और इन केस आप में से किसी को भी कोई सपोर्ट करियर काउंसलिंग रिगार्डिंग चाहिए तो यू कैन कनेक्ट मी ओवर फोन नंबर यू हैव ऑलरेडी ओवर देयर यू आर अ पार्ट इन द ग्रुप एंड यू कैन स्टार्ट दिस जर्नी टू लर्निंग एंड परफॉर्मिंग एज अ करियर काउंसलर एंड वी वुड बी देयर टू हेल्प यू टू स्ट्रेंथन यू टू मूव अहेड थैंक यू थैंक्स अ लॉट Thank you. Bye-bye. Good night.
Bye, yeah. sir.
Can I stop this class here?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, good.
Sir, if there will be more classes for like this?
No, the more classes will
Hello.
Be one-on-one. In case you require to ask something, to learn something, you can connect me between 10 to 12 in the morning time. So I would remain over there to take your calls and to just connect one-on-one. Because in group, the classes will not be there. One-on-one classes can happen over there based upon your requirement, how you can move ahead. Because there will be a specific requirement of individual itself differently. आप सबकी जरूरतें अलग अलग हो सकती हैं, आपके टाइम अलग अलग हो सकते हैं, तो आप मेरे को फोन पे बात करके आप इस जर्नी को आगे ले जा सकते हैं. ठीक है सर.
Right, right.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay, thank you, Radha ji. Thank you, Satish ji. Okay.